God bless you. Get ready for the Almighty God to visit your life right now. Because we're going to make the biggest prayer chain now. And when there is prayer on earth, the skies start to move. And this is what will happen for your life. In this moment of prayer, God's own word says, whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord, and not for men, knowing that from the Lord, you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Christ. In this prayer, we will thank God in all areas of your business, and you can be sure that you will make a great move in all your ways. The first thing I want you to do now is go to the comments and write your first name, and then write the phrase, no attack formed against me, or my business will prosper. I want you to like this video too, because every time you leave your like, you're letting YouTube know that what you're seeing and hearing is good for you, and that it can pass on to other people. That's why it's very important that you leave your like now before praying. I also want to talk to you who are here for the first time. Welcome. I say this every day. Here it's not about religion here. It is about God, praying, and seeking God face. That will bring you many victories. It will bring peace to your heart. It will show you the way to go, so you don't stumble, and so you don't fall. And if you're here, it's because God has a purpose in your life. The direction I give you right now is that you subscribe to the channel. It's free. It is the only way for you to receive the next prayer. Just below, you will find the word subscribe in red letter. I want you to click subscribe. Right after that, you will see a symbol of a bell. Click on the bell, and to finish, you will see the word all. You will also click it, so that every time I send a new powerful prayers, you'll receive it for free through YouTube. From today, I'm adopting you in my prayers. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you, Lord. I worship you, Lord, for you are a good Father. Lord, I lift your name on high, for there is nothing you cannot do. You are faithful in and out of every season. It is you who gives seeds to the sower and blesses to the harvest. It is you who commands an increase and causes multiplication. You are the God of prosperity and divine providence. Your benevolence has existed from the beginning of time. You are a God who delights in giving good gifts to his children. It is you who causes the rain of abundance to fall on our seeds. It is you who blesses the works of our hands. Father, I thank you. Thank you for this business that you have created to be a tool to bless people. Thank you for the wisdom and the insight you have given me thus far in running this business. Thank you for the lives that have been blessed through this business. Thank you for everyone who has benefited one way or another from this business. Thank you for supernatural provision. Thank you, Lord, because my business is still standing despite everything. Thank you, Lord, for my next level, because I know you are about to do something outstanding in my business. Thank you for wealth. Thank you for the resources to expand my business. Dear Father, I am grateful. What was your design when you created Adam? You set him in the garden to work. I know that my business is in your will. It is your design and desire that I put practice my skills and talents for service. It is your will to bless this business. So I ask that, dear Lord, you cause this business to prosper. For every effort of time and money that is placed into this business, I ask that our profit be multiplied. Lord, you are the great investor. Your word is filled with parables of men who were put to work and asked to multiply what they had been given. Lord, I desire to build a profitable business. Multiply my efforts. Dear God, let me reap a thousandfold from my business. Your word tells me that Isaac planted crops and reaped a hundredfold because you had blessed him, because you had placed your hands on him. So Lord, I ask today that you bless my business. Form today we begin to reap a hundredfold. Every effort that is invested is multiplied. Like Isaac, I declare that my wealth continues to grow, and my business continues to expand. Lord, I declare the blessings of Abraham over my life, because you promised in Genesis 12 verse 3, that you would bless all the families of the earth through Abraham. So Lord, I declare I am a blessing. My business is a blessing. I possess the land that has been given to me. My eyes are opened to see the territories that God has ordained for me to take. My eyes and mind are opened to receive wisdom and insights into business. I receive new strategies and techniques for my business. I receive new insights for attracting and retaining customers. The land is mine to possess. My business will grow and expand till it is heard of in nations. My business was built to cater to nations. I receive the blessing of the Lord that causes expansion and increase. The capacity of my business becomes unlimited. We receive the grace to cater to nations. We receive all that we need to possess the nations. My business was not built to cater to my family alone. My business was built to finance the kingdom. My business is a kingdom business. My business is a solution provider. My business was built to finance the spread of the gospel, feed the poor, build national structures, build schools, and build houses. My business was built to take over territories. I receive the land that I have been given through Father Abraham, and I possess the land. Lord, you said to Abraham, as far as your eyes can see, open my eyes to see, dear Lord. Open my eyes to see exactly where you are taking my business and I too. Like Jabez, I pray, enlarge my territories, O God. Expand my capacity. I receive the blessings of God that make me rich and add no sorrow. I declare that I abound in all things. I declare that my business is like a tree planted by the waters, bearing fruit in every season. I declare that no part of my business dies. All that we undertake succeeds, because the hand of the Lord is upon my business. Lord, I commit every part of my business into your hands. We receive divine wisdom to fully utilize every resource at our disposal. We receive the grace for multiplication. We receive the grace of ease and the grace of speed. So I speak to every demonic force that has placed a hand over my business. I rebuke you now, in Jesus' name. I rebuke every locust, cankerworm, and caterpillar that goes about wasting our resources and consuming our profits. Today, I put an end to your activities over my business. I remove every demonic enchantment that may have caused us to make bad business decisions in the past. From today, only the wisdom and counsel of God shall stand in my business. From today, we pledge to seek your counsel before we make any decisions. Lord, I turn over this business to you. Make a success of it. Make an astonishing success of it. Restore to us the years that have been lost, the resources that have been wasted. Restore it to us in a hundredfold. We receive both the former and the latter rain. We receive with gladness everything that we have lost. Lord, open the floodgates of heaven over this business. Rain down your favor over us. Let your mercy speak for us. Let angels advertise this business. Let them go round, bringing customers. Lord, I just take a moment to pray for my customers. I declare that they are blessed in their coming in and in their going out. I declare that the works of their hands are blessed. I declare that their ways are made prosperous. Every time they interact with my business, may they contact the presence of the Lord. I pray for their health. I pray for their peace. I pray, Lord, that your goodness and mercy follow them. I pray that you guide them. I pray that in their hardest seasons, they find you as a comforter. Lord, I ask that you put my business in their hearts. Let them come to love my business. Mark my business with favor. Let men from far and wide come to patronize us. Indeed, let kings come to our rising. Let my business serve kings and dignitaries. Let my business be known far and wide for excellence and competence. Let us be known for our speedy execution. Lord, all that we need to put the necessary structures in place for our upgrade. Lord, we receive. We receive resources in every form. We receive heavy investments that would take this business to the next level. Lord, I pray for diligent staff. I pray for staff who have the fear of God in their hearts. I pray for people who love God and love people. I pray for staff who will remain loyal, staff who give their best to the business. I ask that you open my discerning eyes to discern thieves disguised as staff. I will not open my doors to those here to destroy my business. I receive the grace and wisdom to recognize and deal with fraudulent staff. My business is a business that reflects the kingdom of God. We will love our customers, even the most difficult of them all. We will do all our best to make their lives easier. Everyone who comes in contact with our business experiences the blessing of the Lord. And Lord, as we begin to rake in our profits, I asked for wisdom to steward the resources. We will not be wasters of the wealth that you have given us. We will steward it with the grace you have released to us. Because of this business, nations will be joyful. They will bless God because of us. This business will lend to nations and not borrow. This business will build systems and structures. This business will be everything that God wants it to be, and nothing less. Finally, Lord, I pray for myself. As the great steward of this vision, I pray for an enlightened heart and listening ears. I pray that I remain sensitive to your voice and direction for my business. I ask for health and strength. I ask for peace of mind and peace for my home, so that I can devote myself fully to this business. Greed and dishonesty will have no place in my life. I will reflect the love of Christ in my dealings with both my staff and my customers. My staff will be the happiest around. My customers will be the most satisfied. And at the end of the day, all the glory will be returned to you. Leave your prayer requests in the comments, because I will pray for everything you write in the comments. Look what I'm going to tell you. I ask you not to break this before you leave. I want you to click below on the word share. Copy the link of this prayer. I want you to send it to 12 people. Don't break it. The number 12 represents multiplication. God bless you, great and mighty. So, let's meet here in the next spiritual warfare prayer. Stay with God, and He will bless you. Amen.